So hello everyone, my name is Nati and I'm going to talk about the paper Secret Sharing Schemes for General and Uniform Access Structures, a joint work with Benny Applebaum, Amos Beimel, Oriol Faras, and Oded Neer. So I will start this talk by telling you about what we do in this work. So in our paper, we construct new improved secret sharing schemes for the two types of access structures. And the first is secret sharing schemes for any access structure. And the second is the secret sharing schemes for a specific family of access structure that are called uniform access structures. I will define you later in this talk what are uniform access structures. So secret sharing schemes were defined by Shamir and Blakely for the threshold case, and later by Ito Saito and Nishizeki for the general case. So we have a set of n parties, P1 to Pn, and an access structure gamma, which is a family of subset of parties that contains the authorized set, which I will explain in a minute. For example, one of the best known access structure is the threshold access structure that contains all subsets of parties of size at least k. So the dealer holds the secret S, and it creates random shares S1 to Sn according to the secret and the random schemes, and privately communicates each share SY to the party PI. So in a secret sharing scheme, we want that a set of parties will learn the secret if and only if it is in the access structure gamma. So more precisely, the correctness requirement of a secret sharing scheme is that any set of the access structure is an authorized set that can reconstruct the secret S from their shares by applying some reconstruction function. And the security requirement is that any set that is not in the access structure gamma is an unauthorized set that should not learn any information about the secret. So I will show you a simple example of secret sharing schemes. Consider the following set of two parties, P1 and P2, and the one-bit secret S. And the access structure will be the set of both parties, P1 and P2, which means that parties P1 and P2 should learn the secret, and the party P1 by itself or party P2 by itself should not learn any information about the secret. So in a secret sharing scheme for this access structure, the dealer chooses a random bit R, gives it to party P1, and it gives to party P2 the bit R XOR S. So it is very easy to see that both parties, P1 and P2, can reconstruct the secret S by XORing their shares, and each one of parties P1 and P2 cannot learn any information about the secret since it's all the random bits. So in our work, we consider linear secret sharing schemes. So I will define you linear schemes. So generally, we say that the secret sharing scheme is linear if the shares that the dealer gives to the parties are generated by a linear function. So more formally, the secret is an element for a finite field. And to create the share, the dealer chooses random elements from the finite field. And each share will be a vector over the field in which each coordinate is a linear combination of the secret and the random elements. For example, the previous scheme we saw in the previous slide is a linear scheme. In this scheme, party P1 gets a bit R, and party P2 gets the bit R XOR S. So this scheme is linear over the field F2. So we have some good reasons to study secret sharing scheme. The original application of secret sharing scheme is to store sensitive information and to protect data that should be restricted from some parties. And nowadays, secret sharing schemes are used in many cryptographic protocols, such as multi-party computation, attributes-based encryption, and many more. So now I will tell you about some of the known results for secret sharing schemes. So we measure the efficiency of a secret sharing scheme by the size of the shares. So for this, we define the share size of a secret sharing scheme as the size of the largest share. So the upper bounds for a secret sharing scheme for realizing any access structure, first, Ito Saito and Nishizeki showed the linear scheme realizing any access structure with share size of O of 2 to the power of n. More than 30 years later, this was improved by Liu and Vaikuntanathan. They showed a nonlinear scheme realizing any access structure with share size O of 2 to the power of 0.994n. And they also showed a linear scheme realizing any access structure in which the share size is O of 2 to the power of 0.999n. So let's see what we know about the lower bounds on the share size. So CIRMAS show the existence of an access structure that requires share size of omega of n over log n in any secret sharing scheme that realizes it. And by counting argument, it can be shown that there exists an access structure that requires share size of omega of 2 to the power of n over 2 in any linear secret sharing scheme that realizes it. So as you can see, for general nonlinear secret sharing scheme, there is a huge gap between the best known lower and upper bounds. And for linear scheme, we know much better. So the next slides, I will tell you about our main results, which is a secret sharing scheme realizing any access structure. So for any access structure gamma over a set of n parties, we show a nonlinear secret sharing scheme realizing gamma with share size of O of 2 to the power of 0.892n. We also show a linear scheme realizing gamma with share size of O of 2 to the power of 0.942n. So to construct this scheme, the following schemes, we show a general technique that enable us to construct a better secret sharing scheme realizing any access structure. So next I will tell you about some of the ideas of our schemes. Liu and Vaikuntanathan show that for a parameter delta, we can decompose any access structure gamma to three access structures. The first is gamma top that contains the large sets of size at least half plus delta n. The second is gamma bot that contains the small sets of size at most half minus delta n. And the first is the access structure gamma mid that contains the medium size sets of the size between the above two values. So Liu and Vaikuntanathan show that any access structure gamma equals gamma top intersection gamma mid union gamma bot. So to construct secret sharing scheme for gamma, it is sufficient to construct secret sharing scheme for gamma top, gamma bot, and gamma mid. This follows for non-closure properties of secret sharing schemes. So in our work, we construct improved secret sharing schemes, realizing the access structure gamma top and gamma bot. And this scheme uses combinatorial covers. So now we go over the ideas of the construction. We start with a secret sharing scheme realizing gamma with share size of O of 2 to the power of 0.994n, the scheme of Liu and Vaikuntanathan. We choose set B of size 0.99n. When the value 0.99 is arbitrary, just for the explanation, it can be replaced by any value between half and one. And we consider the access structure gamma B that contains all subsets of parties from the access structure gamma bot that are contained in the set B. So by the result of Liu and Vaikuntanathan, there is a scheme realizing the access structure gamma B with share size of O of 2 to the power of 0.984n. In the next step, we define a cover of the access structure gamma bot as a family of sets B1 to BL of size 0.99n, such that every access structure of gamma bot is contained in at least one of the access structure, in at least one of the sets B1 to BL. So we can decompose the access structure gamma bot as a union of access structure gamma B1 to gamma BL. And by the known closure properties, we can realize independently each of the access structure gamma B1 to gamma BL and get a secret sharing scheme for gamma bot with share size of O of 2 to the power of 0.993n. So for the access structure gamma top, we show a similar secret sharing scheme with the same share size. And using the secret sharing scheme of Liu and Vaikuntanata for the access structure gamma mid, we get a secret sharing scheme realizing gamma in which the share size is O of 2 to the power of 0.993n. So we already get a better scheme than the scheme of Liu and Vaikuntanata. So in the next step, we can do the same, but starting with the access structure with, shares, with the new share size and get an improved share size for the access structure gamma bot in which the share size is O of 2 to the power of 0.992n. So to get our desired scheme, we choose the optimal parameter and use this construction constant number of time recursively, and we get the scheme with the desired share size. So we also analyze the way we choose the optimal parameter to get the optimal share size. In this figure, you can see the optimal choice of the parameter. And overall, we get our scheme with share size of O of 2 to the power of 0.892n, and linear scheme with share size O of 2 to the power of 0.942n. So our analysis can be applied to any secret sharing scheme for the access structure gamma mid, which means that any improvement in the access structure gamma mid will lead to an improved secret sharing scheme for any access structure gamma using our scheme for gamma top and gamma bot. So next I will talk about secret sharing schemes for uniform access structure. Uniform access structure were first defined by Stein and Shi, and later by Beimel, Kushilevich, and Nissim, and Applebaum and Arkis. So uniform access structure is defined by a parameter k between 1 to n, and we call such an access structure k-uniform access structure. In k-uniform access structure, any set of size greater than k is authorized and can learn the secret. Also, some of the sets of size exactly k are authorized and also can learn the secret. And any sets of size smaller than k is unauthorized. So a k-uniform access structure is specified by the set of size exactly k. In other words, a k-uniform access structure contains all the sets of size greater than k and some of the sets of size exactly k. For example, we can consider the next access structure gamma, which contains the sets P1, P2, P3, P2, P4, and P7, and additionally, all the sets of size at least 4. So you can see that this access structure is free uniform access structure. So we have some good motivation of studying secret sharing schemes for uniform access structures. So the first reason is that it is an interesting family of access structure It looks very simple family of access structure. It also has more efficient scheme than the best known secret sharing scheme for general access structures. Uniform access structures can also serve as a test ground for studying secret sharing scheme for any access structures. By recent work, we know that such access structures can be used to construct secret sharing schemes for general access structures. And finally, it equivalent to conditional disclosure of secrets protocol, or shortly CDS protocol, which is a cryptographic primitive that enables a set of parties to disclose a secret to a referee under some conditions. So now we'll tell you about our main results dealing with secret sharing schemes for uniform access structures. So in this work, we construct three secret sharing schemes for K uniform access structures. And the first scheme is a secret sharing scheme for long secrets of size T, and the share size of this scheme is O of K squared times the size of the secret T. In this case, T equals to is at least omega of 2 to the power of n to the power of K squared. The previous best known schemes for such secrets has share size of O of e to the power of k times the size of the secret T. The second scheme we show for uniform access structure is a secret sharing scheme for secrets of 1 bit. And this scheme has share size of 2 to the power of O of square root of k log n. The previous best known scheme for such a secret has a share size of 2 to the power of O of square root of n. Our third scheme for a uniform access structure is a linear scheme for 1-bit secret, and the share size of this scheme is O of 2 to the power of h of k over n times n over 2. So in this case, the function h is the binary entropy function. And the previous best known scheme that is linear has share size of O of 2 to the power of n over 2. So for this scheme, we also show a matching lower bound of omega of 2 to the power of h of k over n times n over 2. And this lower bound shows that our scheme linear scheme is optimal up to a very small polynomial factor. So to construct all the above three schemes, we use implicitly or explicitly a transformation for a multipartite CDS protocol to uniform access structure. So to conclude this talk, in this work, we study secret sharing schemes for general access structures and uniform access structures. We show an improved secret sharing scheme realizing any access structure, and new secret sharing schemes that realize uniform access structures. The open problems that arise from our work is first, try to show an optimal linear secret sharing scheme realizing any access structure. And another question is closing the huge gap on the share size for nonlinear scheme. So there are already some results that uses our work. The first one is a linear secret sharing scheme realizing any access structure in which the share size is O of 2 to the power of 0.762n. And there is a nonlinear secret sharing scheme realizing any access structure in which the share size is O of 2 to the power of 0.64n. And both of these schemes uses our construction for the access structure gamma top and gamma bot. So that's it. Thank you.
We have time for one or two questions. Yes.
So when you say you construct a cover of gamma bot with B1 with sets B1 to BL, so yes. What kind of sets are those, and like what is the number L, and what is exactly their purpose?
The number L, we show a probabilistic proof about the number L. It depends on the size of the sets in the cover.
But this decomposition is meant to like reduce, allow you to combine secret sharing schemes for less general access structures. So I don't understand the goal of this cover set.
About the composition of the gamma bot?
Yes.
So there is a non-closure properties that show that if you have a secret sharing schemes for a few access structure, then there is a secret sharing scheme with the shell with the same shell size for the union or the intersection of those access structures.
And for K uniform access structures, does it matter? Like, shouldn't it matter for efficiency, like the size of the specification? So I don't know if you said you can specify your access structure with the number of sets. So does that matter?
In uniform access structure, yes. The access structure is defined by the parameter K.
Yes, it's the parameter
K. So the shell size will depend on this parameter.
Yes, but it will also depend on the because the specification is on the, like, it's the, because you said it's not all sets on K, but it's a few sets.
It contains some of sets of size K and all sets of size bigger than K. So it doesn't matter which sets of size K do you have in this access structure. You can realize it with the desired shell size.
Thank you. Any more questions? If not, then let's thank the speaker again.